KBIC, Khadi Village Industries Commission, has recently secured trademark registration in three countries, namely Bhutan, United Arab Emirates, and Mexico, which is a big stride towards protecting the identity of brand Khadi globally. So apart from these countries, KBS trademarks are pending already in 40 countries across the world that include the USA, Qatar, Sri Lanka, Japan, Italy, Australia, New Zealand, Singapore, Brazil, and others. So let's see what is this importance of the news, what is the context. What is Khadi Village Industries Commission? It is a statutory body established in April 1957. It was established during second five-year plan under the Khadi Village Industries Commission Act of 1956. It works under Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprise, MSME. KBIC seeks to plan, promote, facilitate, organize and assist in establishing, developing Khadi and village industries across rural areas in association with the other agencies engaged in rural development. It is having its headquarters in Mumbai. Trademark of KBIC. KBIC has exclusive right to use trademark Khadi and Khadi India. Nobody else has. So we have registered trademark, and that's the news now. It also got registered in UAE and also the Bhutan and Mexico. That is the context in which we are talking, and that's why it is in the news. What is Khadi? It refers to, as you know, I'm sure all of you know, when you see the Khadi, we remember Gandhiji's charaka and how he was spinning that cloth. So it refers to hand spun and hand woven cloth. Raw material like cotton, silk or wool can be spun into threads on charaka, traditional spinning implement to obtain Khadi. It was launched in 1920 as a political weapon in Swadeshi movement started by Mahatma Gandhi. So we know that Khadi Village has recently secured trademark registration in three countries. That's the news. Bhutan, UAE, and Mexico. How many countries the KBIC obtained trademark so far? The trademark registration for the word Khadi in six countries, namely Germany, UK, Australia, Russia, China, and European Union. And European Union is already 27 countries, as you can see. However, with trademark registrations in Bhutan, UAE, and Mexico, the number of such countries has gone up to 9. So there's 6 countries, and also this particular UAE and Mexico put together, that make the number to take the number to 9. A trademark, what is a trademark? It's a sign capable of distinguishing the goods or services of one enterprise from those of other enterprise. So nobody should violate that. It is a very unique specific product, uniqueness of that product, and that's a trademark, a distinction, and it distinguishes the goods or services of one business enterprise from the other business enterprises. Product of the one business enterprise to that of the other enterprise. As you know, it's a copyright and trademark, and something like copyright, it is a trademark. And so this trademark distinction only KBIC has and got it registered. So consider which of the following statement regarding KBIC is true. So all the above are correct. KBIC is a statutory body, is correct. It is charged with the planning, promotion, organization, implementation of programs for the development of Khadi, is correct. It functions under the micro, small and medium enterprises ministry. All are correct. Now the other important one is parcel train with 468 tons of cotton yarn from India reaches Bangladesh. A parcel train containing 468 tons of cotton yarn arrived at Benapole in Bangladesh on Tuesday. The train has 20 parcel vans, and it covered a distance of 1700 kilometers after being flagged from the Ambala cantonment station on 27th June. So why in the news? A parcel train containing 468 tons of cotton yarn arrived at Benapole in Bangladesh on Tuesday. It's for the first time that the cotton yarn has been sent from India through the railroad to Bangladesh. Earlier, the cotton yarn was being sent by road in small quantities, which was very expensive. So the best way to send and most economical way is by train. But it has its own operations that you have to take it to the railway station, all those huge tonnage of cotton yarn. Let's talk something about cotton cultivation because it's of relevance here. India is believed to be the originally home of the cotton plant. Cotton is one of the main raw materials for the cotton textile industry. Cotton grows well in drier parts of the black cotton soil of the Deccan Plateau. It's a kharif crop, meaning it is done from June to September and October. Major cotton producing states are Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Punjab, Haryana, and Uttar Pradesh. So these are the cotton producing states. What is the benefits? Actually, it is trading done by a train. Transportation of the cotton yarn by train means cost-effective cross-border transportation of the cotton yarn. That's why it is in the news. For the first time, it was taken in the train. Otherwise, it was taken in small lump sums, in small quantities, by other transportation, and huge costs of transportation were there. So the cotton was being earlier sent in, by road in small quantities, which used to incur huge transportation costs. Bulk mobilization of cotton yarn, a contribution to Bangladeshi clothing and textile business. By sending this huge cotton the cotton yarn to Bangladesh, it facilitated, it promoted their clothing and textile business industry to the Bangladesh. The transportation of consignment of goods by train required the bulk mobilization of the cotton yarn, as you know. The Indian Railways took the initiative to facilitate the movement of small consignment of up to 3,500 tons in each trip, and simultaneously scheduled a special train for Bangladesh. So Indian Railways for the first time took the initiative and made this thing possible. So consignments of 500 tons in each trip, and scheduled a special train, ran a special train for Bangladesh. Consignment will contribute to Bangladesh made clothing and textile business, and it will be a great benefit to them, boost to their economy through this textile business because of this cotton yarn supply by the India. Railways is running timetabled parcel special trains on select routes to ensure an uninterrupted supply of essential items. So this also is a very important thing. What are parcel special train? They are the trains which are run to ensure an uninterrupted supply of essential items, including cotton yarn. So which of the following statement is correct about cotton cultivation? The ideal climatic condition for the production and growing of cotton area required temperatures of 21 to 30 degrees or 50 to 100 centimeter rainfall. Whether black soil is the ideal for the production, right? So answer is C, which means both A and B, which I read it out now. So black soil is the ideal soil, and temperature 21 to 30 degrees and rainfall 50 to 100 centimeter rainfall. Please remember, these studies may be useful in the preliminary question.